Identified on what continent?
Africa.
Correct. What year was 10 years after 50 BC?
40 BC.
Correct. Who played Sir Lancelot in Monty Python and the Holy Grail?
John Cleese.
Correct. Something clangorous affects which of the senses?
Hearing.
Correct. And Michelangelo's Donitondo is housed in what Florence Museum?
The Uffizi.
Correct. A geometrician specialises in what branch of mathematics?
Geometry.
Correct. Tom Petty played with what band from 1975?
Heartbreakers.
Correct. President Truman sacked General MacArthur during what war?
Korean War.
Correct. What nationality links a jumping bean and a wave?
Mexican.
Correct. Prince Consort Henrik is married to which Danish queen?
Margarita.
Correct. What pizza chain sells the Papa's deep crust?
Papa John's.
Correct. Stoic the Vast is the chieftain of Burke in what film series?
Lord of the Rings.
Start the clock. That is wrong. Take your time. Here's your question. Stoic the Vast is the chieftain of Burke in what film series?
I've got no idea.
And given it's Vast and the only chief I can think of is in Asterix and Obelix, who's fat, I'd say Asterix and Obelix, maybe, but I don't know.
OK, Asterix and Obelix.
He's wrong. Correct answer is How to Train Your Dragon. Chase it, your time starts again now. The word lincine relates to what member of a cat family?
Lynx.
Correct. What country is divided into 11 time zones?
Russia.
Correct. OK. We got 14. Two attempts to push back, one executed. Gives us 15. Caught with 34 seconds remaining. But which means we'd have had to set six or seven out of them as well. Gives you, you're looking at 21, 22 maybe. That's the target we'd have had to set.
Yeah.
So once the other two players went out, yeah, it was always an uphill battle.
Yeah.
You know?
He did really well.
Yeah.
But you played well getting there to the final anyway. And don't forget, you romp time, man. You actually beat the chaser in their head-to-heads. You spread the game, so the pair of you. So that's just the way it goes. Unfortunately, you've got to take the $6,000 away and tell you that Jonathan and Becky, finally, you have been caught. For you, the chase is over. Chaser.
First question was difficult because I'm from a sort of particular ethnicity of West Bengali Indians who do have 32 sets of teeth during their lifetime. So for me, that was a little bit of a trick question, to be honest with you. I just didn't hear the word set. I thought, how on earth am I meant to know how many teeth in total you have during a lifetime?
Indeed.
I just said a number and I completely not taken into account the fact that the question said sets. Once I've got over that, though, it was absolutely fine. You needed all four back. The reason you needed all four back is you needed to answer more of the difficult questions. You were pretty good, actually, on the more straightforward ones. You didn't make many silly mistakes. But you needed four players back to get four or five more in that final chase.
Well, there you are. The chaser takes out my team with 34 seconds remaining, and Jonathan and Becky go home empty-handed. I, ladies and gentlemen, mums and dads, boys and girls, have missed my vocation in life. If only I'd been a dentist in Bengal. See you next time on The Chase. Goodbye.
Four possible answers, a seven-figure jackpot, and there's only Chris Durrant. This show has it all. Start the clock for new Classic Millionaire next on Challenge. Weeknights at 7 over on Pick, boldly going where, you know the drill, it's Star Trek Voyager.
Potato. Congratulations, number three. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Sky Arts invites you to join some stellar stars for a very special celebration. As our much-loved series turns 10. With more amazing artists.
I love it.
Will each turn a famous face...
I really love it.
..into a look of love.
Wow.
And like any birthday, expect a special surprise or two.
And are you good at sitting still?
Time will tell.
Portrait Artist of the Year starts Wednesday, 11th of October at 8 on Sky Arts.
Kimberly calculated from the beginning, how do I become famous?
What was it like working with your wife?
Well, it's just time to phone a friend and ask them to be your phone a friend. It's Classic Millionaire on Challenge.
66. Give us a clickety click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
A group of people stand staring up at beams of multicoloured light radiating from a glowing disc, the edge of which is encircled by the show's title, Classic Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Year 5, Episode 5, presented by Chris Tarrant.
Question number 8 is for £8,000. You have £4,000 at this moment. You can use both lifelines and walk away. Have a look at it. You can double your money. Forever Delayed is the greatest hits album by which band? Strokes, Westlife, U2, Manic Street Preachers.
Chris's wife in the audience presses A on her keypad.
What do you think?
I think it's... I've got an inkling it's Manic Street Preachers.
Why?
I've never heard the Strokes. Strokes... I think they're a newish band. You two. Can I phone a friend, Steve?
You can. Who would know?
Chris.
Any kids?
Can I phone Stephen?
Stephen? Okay. Tell him the question. Four possible answers. It's worth £8,000. You don't have to take Stephen's answer, and you can still use 50-50.
Hello?
Stephen?
Speaking.
Hi, it's Chris Tarrant here. Good evening.
Oh, good evening. Hey.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good.
Now, I've got Chris here, Chris Cousins.
Yeah?
As you know, he's doing okay. He's on £4,000, but he's stuck.
Okay.
It's worth £8,000, and he thinks you'll know the answer.
Okay, I'll certainly try.
All right, mate, fingers crossed for you. Chris, you've got 30 seconds. Your time starts now.
Stephen, Forever Delayed is the greatest hits album by which band? Strokes, Westlife, U2, Manic Street Preachers.
Forever Delayed?
Yeah. It's the greatest hits album by which band?
Yeah.
Strokes.
Same game, please. Yeah.
Strokes, Westlife, U2, Manic Street Preachers. 6 seconds.
I'm pretty sure it's the last one, Manic Street Preachers.
How sure?
Host Chris tips his head back and exhales.
I'll go 50-50, Chris, please.
OK. Computer, take away two random wrong answers. Leave Chris the right answer and one remaining wrong answer.
I go D, Chris, Manic Street Preachers.
Final answer?
Final answer.
Are we your instructions about not losing this money?
Don't lose it, yeah. I'll get killed.
You're OK, you're living. You got £8,000. £8,000. It's good. Bearing in mind, you were struggling at £200.
I was struggling.
You got £8,000, right? But you have no lifelines. But question number 9 is worth £16,000. Here we go. Which insect takes its name from the Spanish word meaning fly? Mantis, flea, mosquito, weevil.
In the audience, Chris's wife chooses C.
I've never heard of weevil.
It's worth £16,000. You did not have to play.
I'll play, Chris. Take the money.
It's your call. Have a good look. Which insect takes its name from the Spanish word meaning fly? Mantis, flea, mosquito, weevil. What's your instinct?
The instinct's mosquito.
Why?
Spanish mosquito. Seems Spanish. Wish I had the lifelines left now.
You've got £8,000 at this moment?
Yeah. I think I'll take £8,000, Chris. I can't afford to lose it.
Final answer, you can take the money.
Final answer.
Right, give him a big hand. Chris Chasm goes away with £8,000. I can tell you, Tracy up there, on her keyboard, she reckoned the answer was mosquito. You thought the answer might be mosquito? Mm. The answer was mosquito. But listen, £8,000 is a great result. Yeah. I think your kids will be absolutely thrilled. Yeah, all right, mate, well played. Congratulations.
End of part one.
Congratulations, 82. You're straight on through to the next round.
At Direct Line, we've got car insurance for different kinds of people. Alice likes to have it all. She's got Comprehensive Plus. Then there's Joel, who likes just a few bells and whistles. He's got Comprehensive. Or there's our new Essentials cover for those like Dan who prefer things stripped back. Exactly. So whatever flavour you're after, come direct to compare our prices.
At Co-op, we know those everyday essentials are important. So now, our members will save more on them every day. Sign up and save more at your local co-op.
What the?
The quicker the five, the bigger the prize in New Match 5. Exclusively at Gala Bingo, where a little joy goes a long way.
Shall we?
Everyone's a winner, baby, that's the truth. Anything left to you is that just me.
Get more of what you love with My McDonald's Rewards.
In a backwards world, what if you could move forward? Rewrite the code. Armani Code, the refillable parfum. Giorgio Armani.
Haribo Star Mix?
Yes!
Maybe the bear could steal the ring, which is the crown jewel, can run away with it. Maybe the police can find him.
Yeah.
We are the police!
When it comes to racing, control is the most important thing. And the same goes for betting. So if you feel that your gambling is getting out of hand, you can set limits and rein it in with tools from Coral.
Get autumn ready with 20% off hundreds of new season lines, including all nightwear, all footwear and all denim. In-store, online and on the Matalan app now.
Billionaire takeovers? It's madness.
Oh, they can keep their oil money. Have you heard the news? We've been bought by an oil baron. We're rich!
Loads of money!
Oil money! Loads of money!
Transfer money!
Who cares about F&P? The title is back on!
Well, they've changed their tune. Place a £5 multi-match bet builder on Tuesday's Champions League games and get a free £5 multi-match bet builder to use on Wednesday's games. Paddy Power!
We all love a bit of hanky-panky, don't we? Well, how about some with me, Amanda Holden?
Treat yourself.
Good news, because Sky History have sent me and historian Dan Jones on a sexual odyssey to discover how surprisingly liberated our forebearers really were.
My husband's gonna love it.
I can't wait to show you more.
Hashtag ad.
What? Sex, a bonkers history with me, Amanda Holden. Mondays at 9 on Sky History.
Oh, Queen Bee, you've buzzed too early again.
Part two.
Thanks very much. Welcome back to the second part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Just before the break, very nervous Chris Cousins called it quits to the great relief of even more nervous wife Tracy and went back to Hatfield with a cheque for £8,000 to their delighted kids. Now, we have 10 brand new contestants, all very keen to follow Chris into that seat. Let's meet them. They are Mark Kerr from Merseyside, Louise Firmage from North Yorkshire, John Fitzgerald from North Lincolnshire, Bob Roberts from Nottinghamshire, Angie Wilkinson from Hertfordshire, Jerry Hodge from Hampshire, Vivian Wilson from the Orkney Isles, Clive Harvey from Surrey, Tim Carty from Denbighshire, and John Ball from the West Midlands. Range of waves tonight. Now, time for that opening 10 to play Fastest Finger First. Remember, there are four answers, only one correct order there, and the first of these to find it in the fastest time will be the next to play for £1 million. Nice and quiet, please, in the audience, as always. Here comes the question. Put these artists in the order they were born. Raphael, Tracy Emin, Vincent van Gogh, Roy Lichtenstein.
The contestants lock in their answers.
Incredibly fast reactions there. I don't know whether they were right or not, just very quick. Let's see, this is the right order. Farthest back in time, Raphael, actually born in 1483. Vincent van Gogh, born in 1853. Lichtenstein, born 1923. Tracy Emin, the most recent, born in 1963. So that's the right sequence, that's the right order. Now, out of 10, these were correct. How many? Quite a few. Who was fastest? Mark Kerr in 3.05 seconds. Come on, Mark. Here and then go up there.
Oh, that's all right.
Ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck.
Chris leads Mark to the chairs in the middle of the studio.
Right, this is Mark Kerr, a chartered surveyor from Rainhill in Merseyside. Dad Bill's up there in the audience looking very proud. Mark's wife, also called Tracy, is at home with the kids, Rachel and Helena. With a big win, Mark wants to have a huge barbecue in his back garden, complete with a live band. And to help it happen, he has a good luck charm given to him by a work colleague known as Mystic Rita. Now, not only did she tell Mark he'd get on the show, she also predicted he'd get into that hot seat. But then she didn't say if he'd do any good or not. So she's not that mystic. Mark is just 15 questions away from £1 million. Does sound very easy to say it like that. He gets stuck on the way at all. He has three lifelines, of course, to help him. He's got 50-50. He can phone a friend and he can ask this brand new audience. OK, let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? So let's get you up to £1,000. First of all, question number one is for 100 quid. If you refuse to change your plans despite criticism, you're said to stick to your what? Buns. Guns. Puns. Nuns.
Guns.
You have £100. We'll play. Question number two is for 200 quid. An irritating person might be said to get one's what? Sheep. Pig. Goat. Cow.
That's goat.
You have £200. No problem so far, but just remember those lifelines. If you get stuck on any of these early ones, you would go home with nothing if you gave me a wrong answer. Question number three is for 300 quid. Which word refers to a species of animal that has died out? Extol. Extinct. Extant. extort?
Extinct.
Yeah, £300. Question number four for £500. Simon Cowell is most famous as a sharp-tongued judge on which TV show? Star for a Night, Pop Idol, Model Behaviour, This Is My Moment.
Pop Idol.
You have £500. He's also famous, of course, for wearing trousers that go up above his breasts. Right, you have £500. Last point, Mark, you could go home with nothing at all. Be positive, you have all three lifelines. This question number five would guarantee you £1,000. Watford Gap is a service station on which motorway? M1, M2, M3, M4.
M1.
You have £1,000. Well played, Mark Kirk. Good man. Right so far?
Yeah, fine.
A mystic Rita gave you a lucky Chinese rabbit which you got tucked about somewhere on your person.
That's right.
It's working so far.
Yeah.
Have you been a surveyor literally most of your life?
Yeah, I qualified when I was about 22 and I've been a surveyor ever since.
You went to one house and you actually put your foot straight through the ceiling.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
You felt so embarrassed you bought the house.
Yes, that's right.
Great story. Do you still live in it?
Yes, yeah. Yeah. It's the only time I've ever done that.
Yeah, it's just a weird idea.
I know.
You were doing a thing coming down on the train today from Merseyside. You were doing fastest finger first in the carriage.
That's right,
with Dad.
Yeah.
Which must have bewildered everybody else on the train.
It probably did, but it was a means to an end.
Yeah, well, it worked, because he got you in the chair and you were fastest finger on the first one.
Okay.
And one of your kids, Rachel Helena, Rachel is a phone a friend.
Yes.
Which is very young. 12?
Yes. Yeah.
Fine by us, but it's very young to be phone a friend.
Yeah, but she knows all the modern pop music and all the sort of stuff that
and you don't.
Exactly. Oh, Dad, you must know that. So.
OK. Now, listen, you have £1,000, which is good. You're 10 away from a million. You have all three lifelines intact. Have a look at question number six. This is for £2,000. The French game Patank most closely resembles which game popular in Britain? Darts, bowls, snooker, croquet.
Bowls.
Have you seen it?
I've played Patank, yeah.
Any good?
Not bad, I've had a few pints.
Final answer.
Yeah, final answer, bowls.
That's absolutely right, you've got £2,000. Have a look. Still no need of any lifeline. Question number seven is for 4,000. The Body is the famous nickname of which model? Naomi Campbell, Claudia Schiffer, Iman, Elle McPherson.
Elle McPherson.
Sure. Long time to think about it. Were you just thinking about Elle McPherson?
Well, it's the first name that came up. Yeah. Well, yeah. When the question came up, I thought straight away it's Elle McPherson, and I just thought there was anything to see if anything else came up that would confuse me, but nothing did. So,
final answer.
Yeah, final answer. Elle McPherson.
Absolutely right. You got £4,000. Question number eight is for 8,000. You can double your money here, Mark, and you still have not touched any lifelines. Have a look. Tell me what you want to do. You could lose 3,000 here, so take your time. Which of these battles was fought on a site in Leicestershire? Culloden, Hastings, Flodden, Bosworth.
Bosworth.
Final answer.
Yep.
You have £8,000.
Mark's dad smiles as he applauds.
Dad's looking very pleased with you suddenly, my son. Is he on Little Promise, Daddy, is he? Is there a little something for Dad?
Oh, I'm sure we'll find a little something. I'll probably put him a nice rest home in the Orkney somewhere.
You have £8,000. You've not yet touched the lifeline. This is getting quite serious. You have 50-50, phone a friend and ask this audience. Question number nine is for £16,000. You would lose seven here if you gave me a wrong answer. Have a look. Which word links a style of architecture and a style of melodramatic literature? Aeolic, Doric, Gothic, Hellenic.
Yeah, that's Gothic.
Final answer?
Yeah.
It's the right answer. You've got £16,000. Are you calm?
Yeah, very.
You look very calm.
Well, it's more nerve-wracking in those seats than in this one.
Right, serious business. You have £16,000. You have all three lifelines intact. Question number 10 would guarantee you a cheque for £32,000. Have a look at it. This is question number 10 of a possible 15. Whose last words were believed to have been, "Thank God I have done my duty"? Lord Nelson, Henry VIII, Duke of Wellington, Winston Churchill.
Not sure, it's not a quote I've heard before, to be honest with you. Only one seems to fit.
So which one?
The one I think that might fit is Lord Nelson. Because he died in battle. But I'm not sure.
Get rid of two.
I'll use a 50-50 here, Chris.
Okay, computer, take away two random wrong answers. Leave marked the right answer and the one remaining random wrong answer. Nelson's still there, and Henry VIII.
Well, Henry VIII's last words was monks, monks, or something, so it's not his.
What?
Monks, monks, I think. So I'm going to play Lord Nelson.
Lose 15 grand if you're wrong. Are you a fabulously wealthy surveyor?
No, I'm a fabulously overdrawn surveyor. So,
Final answer.
Final answer, Lord Nelson.
You just won £32,000. What he's believed to have said as he died at Trafalgar. Right, have a look. That's what you've achieved so far. Whatever happens tonight, take it. It's yours.
No, you keep on doing it, thanks.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right, whatever happens tonight, Mark, you go home with that amount of money, 32,000. Okay. Now, what does that mean? Two daughters, dad, family, mum's still alive. It's quite a big old family to look after.
It's not much each, is it?
Okay, what would you do? I mean, obviously, people think about this before they come on and think, well, if I got to that.
I haven't thought that. I thought it was rather tempting providence to think that far ahead, so I've just merely taken each step at a time, you know.
OK. Well, you have £32,000. Whatever happens, that's guaranteed. You are five away from £1 million. You have two lifelines intact. You've still got to phone a friend, and you can still ask this audience. Have a look, question number 11, Mark. This is one you can play anyway. You might as well play this. You can't lose on this one. It's worth £64,000. You're guaranteed 32. Question number 11 of a possible 15. Ithaca and Cephalonia belong to which group of islands? Cyclades, Dodecanes, Ionian, Aegean.
His dad presses C on his keypad.
I don't know. I'm thinking I might have to enlist the help of our audience here. I really don't know. I mean, I know some of the Greek island groups and some of the main islands, but I'm not sure which group these two belong to. Never been to either of them. So, my inclination, I think I'll ask the audience. They look a well-travelled group, so.
OK. OK, right, audience, let's try and get Mark up to £64,000. All on your keypads, please. Let's see what we get. This is the question. Ithaca and Kefalonia belong to which group of islands? Now, A on your keypad is Cyclades. B is Dodecanese. C is Ionian. D is Aegean. A, B, C, or D, all vote now. Aegean. 39% Ionian. 12% Dodecanese. 8% Cyclades. It's your call, really. It's a majority, but it's not a huge one.
Palms together, marks deep in thoughts. End of part two.
You'll be good at this one.
Ready to change your hair colour for good? Garnier Good, our new generation of permanent hair colour. 90% natural origin kit. No ammonia. Apply like a mask. Feels good. Glossy colour. Greys are gone. Feel good that shows. Change your hair colour for good. By Garnier. Naturally.
What about more family time instead of overtime?
Works for me.
And what if you didn't have to leave home at 6 to work at 9? And what if it didn't take forever to hire the one? What if better work was something we can find? Or better yet, something that found us?
Ladbrokes presents Slot Rivals. There's a brand new way to play slots for free. Compete with other players, head to head, by unlocking special weapons to take on your rivals. Earn points to get on the daily leaderboard for a chance to win amazing prizes like bonuses, free spins, and cash. Play for free at ladbrokes.com.
Come on, Jan, release your energy.
It's releasing my pee I'm worried about.
And my ThinkPad showing.
Then we're always discreet like me.
Watch this.
Wow. Where did it go?
Who cares? It protects and it's so much thinner.
I'm letting it all go.
Always discreet. Strong protection. Incredible discretion.
And did you know how common bladder leaks are at menopause? Find out how to manage them at the free masterclasses up here at alwaysdiscreet.co.uk.
Hey, mate. We can help you juss it up. No stock pots. They'll do the trick.
There we go.
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
Drop it straight in and watch the magic begin.
Ooh. Proper tasty.
More oomph, more flavour.
Do you guys live in our cupboard?
Mm. It's a bit of a tight squeeze.
In a backwards world, what if you could move forward? Rewrite the code. Armani Code, the refillable parfum. Giorgio Armani.
Dreaming of long yet visibly healthy hair? Now you can take it to infinity. Discover new Pantene Infinite Length Serum, infused with Pro-V Blend, Niacinamide and Vitamin E. It helps to repair and strengthen, smoothening all the way to the tips. Unleash stronger and infinitely long hair. New Pantene Infinite Length Collection. Luxury care without the luxury price. Pantene.
The search for Sky Bet's real football number ones is nearly over. We've scoured the UK, trawled through hundreds of nominations and met your local legends, people who make football better for everyone. Very soon, our independent panel will select who will win a money can't buy prize, fit for a real football number one. Search Sky Bet Real Football Number Ones to watch our nominees' full stories. Sky Bet, the UK's number one betting app.
Ten years. 576 participants, 220 sitters,
but only 9 winners, who are back for their biggest test yet.
We're very pleased to see you back again.
And crowning the champion of champions requires a very special guest.
You have 4 hours to capture Judy Dench.
I'm feeling intense.
The essence of Judy is there.
Time is up.
They are fantastic.
The winner of Portrait Artist of the Decade is...
Portrait Artist of the Decade, Wednesday at 8 on Sky Arts.
Number 13. That's unlucky.
Part 3.
I think I'm going to have to phone a friend. I just don't know.
OK. You got anybody who wouldn't know?
I'm trying to think who's probably been to Greece. I think I'll ring Pat.
Pat? OK. Lady Pat?
It's a man Pat.
Man Pat, OK. Well, phone Pat, tell him the question. 4 possible answers. Do you want me to tell Pat it's worth £64,000?
Yeah, absolutely.
OK.
Hello?
Pat?
Hello?
Hiya, it's Chris Tarrant here, good evening.
Oh, hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
Well, now, we're on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, as you, as I'm sure you gather, and it does mean the fact we're calling you means that Mark Kerr's in the chair.
Tremendous.
He's doing OK, actually, he's doing rather well. It does put a certain amount of pressure on you, though, because he's stuck at this point, and your answer's worth £64,000.
OK.
OK, fine. All right. OK, right, Mark, yeah, 30 seconds. Pat, that's the next voice you hear. It'll be Mark's. 30 seconds. Good luck, mate. Time starts now.
Ithaca and Kefalonia, spelt A-I-T-H-A-C-A and C-E-P-H-A-L-O-N-I-A, belong to which group of islands? Cyclades, Dodecanese, Ionian and Aegean. That's Ithaca and Kefalonia. 10 seconds, Pat. 8, 7.
Ionian.
Sorry?
Ionian.
Ionian. How sure?
90%. I think, yes.
90%, and then the word, I think. 29.5 seconds.
Well, Pat's pretty good, and his 90% is most people's 100%. I don't know. I've got to have a go because it's a shot to nothing. So I'm going to go for Ionian.
Final answer.
Yeah.
It's the right answer. You have £64,000.
After laughing, Mark mimes wiping his brow. His dad smiles and claps.
And that's the first time you've looked flustered, wasn't it?
I just didn't know it.
Yes.
Simple as that.
Right. Have a look. You've used up your lifelines, but you now have that amount of money.
Okay.
64 grand. OK, uh-huh. Put it there.
Okay.
Now, have a look. You are 4 away from 1 million. 4 right answers. Question number 12 is worth £125,000. These are now very serious amounts of money. You do not have to play this question, Mark. You can walk away £64,000 better off, which is a fantastic night. But question number 12 will take it up to £125,000. It's question number 12 of possible 15. Here it comes. To which of these does the word vitellin refer? Nutshell, bacon rind, egg yolk, tree sap.
It's a word I've never heard before. I don't think it's bacon rind. And I don't think it's egg yolk. So I think it's between the other two. So I suspect it's nutshell or tree sap. I said if I got to this situation and didn't know,
come and have a go at something. So whatever happens, I'm going to have a go.
It's a lot of money. You've got 64,000 this point.
Well, if I fail, I fail, but at least I fail trying.
To which of these does the word vitellin refer? Nutshell, bacon rind, egg yolk, tree sap. One of those is worth £125,000.
I suspect it comes from the Latin word for life, vita. But, you know, I suppose they get life in egg yolks and tree saps and inside a nutshell, I suppose.
Which of these does the word vitellin refer? Nutshell, bacon rind, egg yolk, tree sap. You've got £64,000. You can walk away.
I'm sure it's not bacon rind. Absolutely sure. I can't think what on earth that's got to do with vitellin. Tree sap provides nutrients to the tree. Egg yolk obviously contains life. Nutshell. It's a case with life inside it. So I'm between C and D now, between egg yolk and tree sap. I just don't know which way I'm going to go. I really don't know. I'll have a stab at egg yolk.
Not tree sap.
No, well, it could be, I don't know.
No, I'm not.
On the basis that I don't know, but I'd made a decision on the way here that if I got to 64 and I didn't know, I'd have a go because I can get to 125, the road's open to large amounts of money. If I get down to 32, well, sound fair, I am. I'd at least have gone down, trying. So I'm going to have a stab at egg yolk.
Final answer.
Yeah.
Mark, you've just won £125,000. Oh! Hey, great!
Hey!
Hey, great! Oh!
Mark's dad is grinning. The studio spotlights point downwards.
You got no lifelines. You are three away from a million. How do you feel now? You're still very calm.
Yeah, well. It's where I wanted to be for the last 2 years, and I wanted to be in those seats to get into here, and I've got here, so this is great. Yeah. My destiny's in my own hands.
It is entirely now. You have no lifelines. But question number 13 is worth £250,000. You do not have to play this question. You've got 125 grand at this moment, which is a huge amount of money to take home to the wife and kids, and probably almost certainly something for Dad up there. But give me a wrong answer. Apparently not. But if you give me a wrong answer at this point, Mark, I just remind you, I'm sure you know the sums, but you would lose. You still got £32,000. You would lose £93,000.
Okay.
Not great. Right. Have a look. Take your time. Question number 13 of a possible 15 is this. Vidkun Quisling was a traitorous leader of which country during World War II? France. Italy. Norway. Turkey.
Norway.
Let's take our time, Mark, shall we?
I knew it before the options came up, it's Norway.
I saw it in your eye, actually.
Yeah.
We'll say that only Quisling. Easy if you know the answer. You want to play this?
Yeah, I'm going to play Norway.
Final answer?
Yep.
You've just won £250,000. Woo! There, you want one back? I told you, we didn't want to give you that. We didn't give you that. Right. You now have this check. Quisling is now a word used just about everywhere for a traitor.
Yeah.
As you know. Right, have a look at that one. You're getting a bit keen. There's a little bit of a shake there, Mark.
I just sort of get the prize out of your grasp.
It's yours. You can take it.
No, go on, you keep hold of it. You've done well for me so far.
Right, you have a quarter of a million. You are two away from a million. Serious stuff.
Yeah.
Have a look, yeah? Have a look at question number 14. It's worth £500,000. I will warn you, if you give me a wrong answer at this point, you lose £218,000.
OK.
You do not have to play this question. You're a quarter of a million pounds better off at this moment. Question number 14, though, is for half a million. Here it comes. In Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, which of these characters does not die? Mercutio. Tybalt. Benvolio. Romeo.
I've actually got it on video and I've watched it about halfway through. Had I watched it all the way through, I'd have known the answer. But I don't know the answer. I've had several dreams of being on this show, and every one I've won £250,000, and I can't believe it, but I'm at the point now where I've got to stop, because I don't know the answer.
You know what I did?
No, I know Romeo finds Juliet dead and then kills himself, so I think he dies. And one of his best friends murdered at the beginning. I think it's Tybalt, so it must be one of the other two, but I don't know which one it is. And frankly, I don't care.
If only you'd watched a bit longer.
I know. It's cost me like £250,000.
Well, it might have done.
But I don't know, so I'll have to stop.
Been amazing. You've been so calm right the way through. Final answer, you can take the money.
Yep.
Yep. OK, give Mark Kerr a huge hand. He goes back to Merseyside. A quarter now. Do you want to take it now?
Yeah, go on.
I thought you might now. It's yours. £250,000 better off. Fantastic. And I don't know whether the audience here saw the whole of the video that you didn't, but I can tell you on their keypad, 60% of this audience voted for Benvolio, and Benvolio was the right answer.
Clever audience.
Clever audience. Too late now for you, but too late. Well, what a night. A quarter of a million. Well played,
thanks,
mate.
Chris.
Fantastic. Mark Kerr, £250,000.
Mark walks out of the studio.
An amazing bloke. Cool as a cucumber. Mark Kerr goes home to Merseyside with a cheque for a massive £250,000, quarter of a million. I bet when he walks into work on Monday, Mystic Rita tells him she knew that would happen. Now, we have nine contestants left to play Fastest Finger First. Nice and quiet, please, in the audience. They're itching to get in that seat. They've seen the sort of money that's around. Here comes the next question. Starting at the top, put these football teams in the order they finished in the Premiership of the 2002-2003 season. Arsenal, Leeds United, Manchester United, West Ham.
The contestants lock in their answers.
Not sure quite what happened there. A lot of them were beating their computers in anger. Let's see. This is the right order. This is last season, basically. 2002-2003, Man U. First place. Arsenal were second. Leeds were 15th. West Ham, 18th place. So that's the order. Now, out of our nine remaining contestants, who got it right? Let's have a look. These were correct. 1, 2, 3, 4. Who was fast? John Fitzgerald. Very fast time, John. 2.61. You know your football. Good man, we'll play. That's the seat. Got a little bit more money. There's not a lot of about tonight.
Chris leads John over to the seats in the middle of the studio.
Right, Right, it's been a big money night. We have John Fitzgerald now, technical engineer from Scunthorpe in North Lincolnshire. Wife Lena's up there in the audience. They have four kids and a three-month-old granddaughter, Madison. John's job has him fixing things all over the world, including a time in the Falklands when he was dropped off on a tiny island by helicopter and then got stuck inside the boiler he was meant to be mending. With a big win, he wants a trouble-free cruise around the Caribbean, and if he did win a million tonight, John says it would take 24 hours to sink in, then 24 hours to sober up. 15 questions, three brand-new lifelines, £1 million. John, lots of luck. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Question number one is for £100. If something is described as skew-with, it is what? Mouldy, smelly, crooked, hot.
That's crooked, Chris.
That's right, answer, you got £100. Question number two for £200. What are you said to be on if you're in a state of tension or suspense? Meat hooks, butcher's hooks, fish hooks, tenter hooks.
That would be tent hooks.
You have £200. Question number three for £300. Which of these is a former head of the BBC Weather Centre? Bill Gates, Bill Paxton, Bill Murray, Bill Giles.
I knew I was going to get one that was going to stump me, but I didn't know it was going to be this early.
Not ring a bell at all, would it?
Can I ask the audience, please, question?
You can. Audience, on your keypads, please. Let's get John up to at least £300. This is the question. Which of these is a former head of the BBC Weather Centre? Now, A is Bill Gates. B is Bill Paxton. C is Bill Murray. D is Bill Giles. All vote now. Two 2% think Bill Gates is a former head of the BBC Weather Centre. It's a worry, isn't it? Might be right. 7% are saying Bill Paxton, 3% Bill Murray, 88% say Bill Giles. It's your call.
I'll go Bill Giles.
Do you ring a bell with you yet?
It does now, but it's one of those things. All I kept seeing, every time I was looking at it, I've seen Bill, Bill, Bill. I get enough of them through the door. And you get someone like that, think, uh-oh, here we go.
Richard, don't worry, that's what lifelines are for. You want to play this, yeah?
Yes, please.
It's the right answer, Bill Giles. You have £300.
End of part three.
At legs 11, are you sure you've got enough room there?
Well, you got to work with when your eyes are closed in the forest. What you got in your pocket? Superb! And on a cold and wet Tuesday night, who you got?
William Hill, it's who you play with.
Devotion by Dolce & Gabbana, a new fragrance for her.
McDelivery? You in?
I'm in.
I'm in! McSpicy!
Medium meal. And I want strawberry milkshake.
I need a Big Mac.
Two Big Macs, please! I'm in!
Two McPlants, six McNuggets, extra ketchup. A McFlurry in every flavour. Thanks!
McFlurry!
Chicken McNugget!
McDelivery!
Double cheese burger! I'm in!
There's nothing quite like a McDelivery. You in? Oh, I'm in.
Herbal Essences presents...
What a feeling! What a feeling! What a feeling!
You won't believe it. The power of herbal essences, infused with argan oil. Hair is up to 2 times more nourished. Herbal essences, what a feeling.
I love it when I can dry my clothes outside, but the weather doesn't always cooperate.
Very outdoorable fabric softener makes our washing as fresh as if it's been dried outside, even when drying inside. Mmm, that outdoor freshness. And still so soft, even next to sensitive skin. Very outdoorable, very soft, and fresh as if dried outside.
Coral's new rewards grabber is now better than ever. Free to play each day, win a guaranteed prize from cash rewards to coral coins. Every single time. The new improved rewards grabber from Coral. Get more in every grab.
You're built different, never stopping until you find the right part at the right price. That's the eBay way.
Houston, we have a problem. It's madness.
Kimberly calculated from the beginning, how do I become famous?
What was it like working with your wife?
Join Sky Arts for the celebratory series.
I'm very excited.
As Portrait Artist of the Year.
I really love her.
Turns 10.
In this series, me and historian Dan Jones,
ding ding,
are pulling back the cover on 5 periods of history. This is going to be quite a ride.
Now that's what I call lucky.
Part 4.
Don't worry about it, that's exactly what lifelines are there for. Let's get you up to £1,000. Question number 4 is for £500. Which of these is an attachment for a hairdryer? Infuser, suffuser, diffuser, refuser.
I can't believe this. Can I play a 50-50, please?
You can. Computer, take away 2 wrong answers. Leave you on the right answer and 1 remaining wrong answer. One of those is an attachment for a hairdryer, suffuser or diffuser.
I'll go diffuser.
Final answer.
Final answer.
It's the right answer. You just won 500 quid. Oh, how you feel, John?
I felt all right till I sat here. But...
Listen, you're still there. You got £500.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get you up to £1,000. You still have 1 lifeline. Question number 5 is for £1,000. A knees up alludes to the dance performed by which character in the old song title? Old Ma Black, Mrs. Grey, Mother Brown, Grandma White.
He's listening to me now. Mother Brown.
It's the right answer. You have £1,000.
Oh. I'm making hard work of this.
Yeah, well, I would say they're only easy if you know the answer. Have a look at question number 6. This is for £2,000. You might as well play it. You have a phone a friend. Which member of the royal family left the Marines to work for the really useful theatre company? Prince Andrew, Prince Philip, Prince Edward, Prince Charles.
That'll be Prince Edward, Chris.
Final answer?
Final answer.
It's the right answer. You have £2,000. Question number 7 is worth £4,000. You are 9 away from a million. You have a phone a friend. Here it is. Which of these was a UK number one hit single for Roxy Music in 1981? Happy Guy, Crazy Guy, My Guy, Jealous Guy. It's worth £4,000. Yep, on your pop?
No.
Ah.
Not one bit.
Have you got an inkling at all?
I think it's Jealous Guy. Because My Guy, that was on Motown. I'd like to phone David, please.
Dave?
Yeah.
OK. Tell him the question. Tell him it's worth £4,000. Where's Dave? Back up in Scunthorpe?
Yeah.
All right, phone Dave. Hopefully give you the right answer. If not, it's your call what you do. But you've got £2,000. It's worth £4,000.
Hello?
Dave?
Who's that?
It's Chris Tarrant. Good evening.
Oh, hello.
Who are you?
My name's Dave.
I thought, I know it is. Well, you know when you said you'd be a phone-a-friend?
Indeed.
To John, and he's on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Yes.
Well, this is sort of how it works.
Yes.
So it's phone-a-friend time.
Yeah.
So John's doing OK, but he's stuck on a particular question. It's worth £4,000. All right, mate.
OK.
OK, right, the next voice you hear will be John to tell you the question. There are still four possible answers. One of these is worth £4,000. Good luck, John. Your time starts now.
All right, Dave. Which one of these was a UK number one hit single for Roxy Music in 1981? Happy Guy, Crazy Guy, My Guy or Jealous Guy?
Jealous Guy.
Jealous Guy. I thought it was. 100%?
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks very much, Dave.
OK.
Cheers.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. That was right. Jealous Guy.
I was right. You hope you were right.
Yeah.
Final answer?
Final answer.
You just won £4,000. Well played.
The end.
Show off both brains and darting prowess next on Challenge as our throwers and knowers step up to the Occhi for Bullseye. Weeknights at 8 over on Pick, Magnum PI will need all his brains and brawn to stop all sorts of poop plug going on in Hawaii.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecha Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
I keep my home fresh with Febreze 3 Volution plugin.
And I use this.
Febreze has smart programming to digitally control how much scent is released, so you never stop noticing freshness for up to 90 days.
Does mine have smart programming?
Mm-mm. Oh, Febreze also has a refill reminder light, so I never miss a day of freshness.
Wow, it's so fresh!
Febreze 3 Volution.
Keep noticing the freshness and discover our new plastic-free refill pack design.
At Direct Line, we've got car insurance for different kinds of people. Alice likes to have it all. She's got Comprehensive Plus. Then there's Joel, who likes just a few bells and whistles. He's got Comprehensive. Or there's our new Essentials cover for those like Dan who prefer things stripped back. Exactly. So whatever flavour you're after, come direct to compare our prices.
What the?
Huh?
The quicker the five, the bigger the prize in New Match 5, exclusively at Gala Bingo, where a little joy goes a long way.
10 years, 576 participants, 220 sitters,
but only 9 winners, who are back for their biggest test yet.
We're very pleased to see you back again.
And crowning the champion of champions requires a very special guest.
You have 4 hours to capture Judy Dench.
I'm feeling intense.
The essence of Judy is there.
Time is up.
They are fantastic.
The winner of Portrait Artist of the Decade is...
Portrait Artist of the Decade, Wednesday at 8 on Sky Arts.
The arrows are out. Play for prizes or your BFH. It's Bullseye on Challenge.
Congratulations, number 3. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Bullseye. Billy the Bull drives a coach full of darts players in the cartoon opening sequence, to your surprise to see a dart fly past their window. Bully presses the eject button and now clings onto the flight of a flying dart, circling a dartboard before hitting it.
Welcome to another edition of Bullseye. Thanks very much indeed for watching us once again on this Sunday evening. I just want a little word and like to thank Mrs. Burney of Hull. And she read in the Hull Daily Mail in the birthday column that apparently I share a birthday with a very, very famous Oriental gentleman. Have a look at this.
His photo's captioned as Rajiv Gandhi.
So all I'd like to say to all of you is, Hamari contestant go miley on Bullseye. Thank you very much. Let's get on with the game tonight.
Jim descends the studio steps.
How are you? Right. Nice to see you, Colin.
Hello, Susan. How are you?
Fine.
All right, you look smashing. You look great. And your brother and sister?
Yes.
That's right, isn't it? What's your job, Colin?
Roof tiler.
Roof tiler? That's the sort of job people look up to, isn't it? Now, listen, you're leaving the country, aren't you? You're going to... Tell us where you're going.
Canada.
Have you actually got in there?
No, I've got a job, but